statement, just about 3 minutes or so of an opening statement. You're welcome to stand or sit, whatever you prefer.
Sure. So my name is Christy Inskip, and you know, I grew up on a farm in a rural area, and my dad was a mechanic and a farmer and a small business owner, and my mom was a teacher's aide who worked for the school district until she went back to school and became a registered nurse. And you know, I grew up struggling. I grew up knowing what it was like to struggle, and that was one of the reasons why I got into public service. I currently work in Lane County Public Health as the Tobacco Prevention Coordinator. I work to protect children from a lifelong deadly tobacco addiction. And I work with local jurisdictions, county, cities, and other organizations to help make that happen. I have worked over 12 years in local and state government and I work to ensure transparency and that taxpayer dollars were spent responsibly. I have decided to run because I want to make sure that every person has a voice in the Capitol. And I want to make sure that we have someone that has more in common with constituents, that's in touch with constituents. I believe that it's important to have elected officials that are in touch with what our needs are. And so I decided to run to help give us a voice in the Capitol. Some of the things that I want to address are jobs and supporting local businesses. So I would like to, in order to do that, I think that it's important to not only support our small local businesses, but also to focus on career and technical education in the schools. And also make sure that workers have fair living wages and fair benefits and fair work conditions. One of the other areas that is a priority of mine is education. So I would like to make sure that our education system is is adequately funded and prioritized in the state budget. And when we look at increasing access to early childhood education, which we know will lead to better outcomes for the children. And also focus on improving K-12 opportunities and increasing civics and arts in the schools again. And also focusing, like I said, on career and technical education and improving those graduation rates for our high school kids. The other area is improving access to healthcare. We really need to focus on improving access to healthcare in our rural communities, and that's one of the priority areas that I would like to focus on, which includes looking at recruiting and training and retaining healthcare providers in our rural areas. So also focusing on decreasing costs of prescription medications as well. And also looking at improving access in other ways, such as telemedicine, in our rural communities as well. So those are some of the areas that I have heard from the community around the district. I've been out knocking doors and talking to people. And those are the three areas that people mention the most are priorities to them. So I have made those my priorities as well, and want to really roll my sleeves and work on these things in the legislature for regular folks. I want to make sure that I'm representing regular folks and not corporate interests, and that is my priority.
Thank you very much. Three minutes and 8 seconds.